enthusiastic reception. The name of my report is every single day in the 3-year-long expedition of Captain Meriwether Lewis and Captain William Clark. I'm sure you will find it fascinating as well lengthy. I mean thorough. On the first day of their famous adventure, the two young explorers woke up. Then they washed up for breakfast. Then they ate breakfast. Then they washed the dishes. Then they went for a canoe ride. Then they...
to lead the expedition.
That's right, he is. And I know that I'm William Clark, the other victim. I mean captain, that was asked to make the trip.
And I'm Charbonneau, the clumsy guide and interpreter. At least I think I am. Am I?
I'm Sacagawea, the guide for the group, and Charbonneau's wife.
You are? Oh, I mean, yes, you is. I mean, I was. I mean, you are. I mean, I do.
Oh, brother. I'm certain that I'm the slave who made the trip. They call me York.
Research?
Yes. You see, I was supposed to give a report today to my class today about the adventures of Lewis and Clark.
That's...
Yeah, I know. Clark and Lewis. I don't care if you're Garfunkel and Simon.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
My report says that you've been home since 1806. Now, why should anyone believe anything I say?
Don't get all upset, little girl. We'll explain the whole thing to you.
We'll give you a first-hand account of our trip.
It was wonderful.
It was eventful.
It was eye-opening.
It was rough.
Let's tell her all about it. Hit it, fellas.
Land. We had no plan to show the way to a man who left his stake.
lady. Well, don't look like you should. We had quite enough of that for a while.
That's for sure. Tell about how you shot Captain Lewis right in the rear because he's fighting to know, Charbonneau.
Ooh, yeah, that was rough!
Oh, she doesn't want to hear about that.
Neither do I.
What I don't understand is why President Jefferson was so keen at having you do the trip in the first place. After all, that territory wasn't real part of the United States at the time. Was it?
No, she wasn't, but Jefferson already dispatched two very capable fellows.
James and Earl Robert Livingston.
Two friends to buy some land from the Edward Napoleon Bonaparte, who was way over his head for fighting wars all over Europe.
Not that over his head was very high, but frankly, my dear, he was pretty well broke.
Sounds like a good time for a deal. My dear!
Look over there!
We better do it. She's the guy, you know.
Gentlemen, all eyes, all hopes are now fixed on you, and the events of this mission depends on the future destinies of this republic.
No kidding, Mr. President?
Gee, heavy stuff, isn't it?
Really rough!
Monroe Livingston bought a lot more than they originally intended.
Yeah, like 860,000 miles.
Sort of like the Blue Light Special land deals.
The truth is, we didn't even know what America owned when we set out on our journey. I thought we were just going on a little canoe ride or something.
Many Americans had some strange ideas about ownership in that time in our history.
You can say that again.
Are you kidding? This is an adventure of a lifetime.
It was spectacular.
It was so enlightening.
What trip?
It was free.
It was magnificent.
It was glorious.
It was stupendous.
Wait, stop. Hold it. I can't believe I'm hearing this, and I'm known to have some pretty good ears. Good grief, fellas. Give me some music.
Now, baby, let me give it to you straight. From one who did the entire trip on four little paws and not a hydrant in sight, they can tell you it was this great adventure. full of romance, excitement, and thrills. But let me tell you right now that no matter what they say, and no matter how they say it, the truth of the matter is that the whole doggone trip was absolutely, positively, undeniably rough!
No kidding, lady.
Well, Scanlan is right to a certain degree. It can be a pretty trying adventure at some times, what with wild animals, miserable weather, and trying to keep the native population from doing us in.
What about the native populations? What was your reaction to your visiting their lands?
What do you guys say to Leah? Probably that's the best answer to those questions.
Really? She's the guide, you know.
And your wife?
She is? Oh, I mean, yes. She is? Wow.
It's true. We would have never made it without Sacagawea and her skills as guide interpreter.
Sacagawea, how do people respond to their visitors from the east?
Always very beautiful.
All is more beautiful in life is thankfulness.
These guests
expert mastering of the sciences of astronomy, geography, geometry, physics, meteorology, and all the earth sciences, mastered their innate sense of direction, mind, and form that they got us to and from our manifest destination with a nary single miscue.
In other words, we got lucky.
Oh, wandering through.
Yes, indeed. There were times like that.
Like when we thought the stew were going to do us all in.
Or when we nearly froze to death the winter we spent with a mandans.
Or how about the time we saw 220 grizzly bears in one day?
That's right. One of them almost had Charbonneau for lunch.
Really?
That was bad, all right. But I think the worst thing is with those who took the nest pure south of the Columbia River. We ate nothing but salmon and dog meat for weeks on end.
Rock, 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 rock!
Ah, yes, the Columbia. That's when for sure we're going to make it to the Pacific.
After making it past the Great Falls of Missouri, I thought I'd never want to see a rushing river again.
We had made it over the entire chain of Rocky Mountains. Needless to say, we were pretty battered.
Then Captain Clark discovered a large river we called Clearwater. That led us right into the mighty Columbia.
Then we met up with the Nez Perce Indians who saved our lives through their kindness and generosity.
They fed us.
And helped us build new dugout canoes that got us back on that beautiful river, making its tumbling dash to the sea.
Thank you.
so real. I guess it was too good to be true. Lewis, Clark, Sacagawea, is it really you? Oh, hi, Leah. It's only you.
Cassie, you absolutely never believe what just happened to me. I was working on my report about King Arthur and his knights at the Royal Round Table, and you'll never believe who came knocking at my door.
King Arthur and his knights?
No, that would be impossible. They've been dead for hundreds of years.
Well, who then?
Two guys named Clark and Lewis and a whole group just home from a cross-country expedition.
We're back!
Teachers that helped us with the play and made it possible. It was a pretty good performance. I just want to ask if they could all come up here. Mrs. Mergillo, Mr. Yu, Miss Rose, Miss Rickman, Mr. Resby, over there.